Namibia is a semi-arid country in sub-Saharan Africa. Due to its climatic conditions, the country is highly vulnerable to the impacts of climate change. The Oshana region, one of Namibia's 14 regions, is situated in north-central Namibia. The region has been hard hit by climate change, especially during droughts. Non-climatic issues such as unemployment, a prevailing patriarchal system, and gender norms already put women at risk. Extended droughts and occasional floods due to climate change represent a real threat to their livelihood.
Ongwediva constituency is one of the most populated constituencies with a population of 34,065 inhabitants. And it's also the constituents that accommodate most of the educational institutions.
Otuna elunduluko longalo mepopeife ngashinga tashuya nandoko ko dula efimbolo lo dula tailoko otuete kucha elunduluko lihapu odulo ya lundulula ya lunduluka iheilo kwali ngashia kala nale
ngashie mongo dambure to odo danangarado odawa poko dula mo 2011 odura yali aloka yalokomea ngengaja kushekwi apeshopomea fio meumbu
oi ya gomu tingo tula ya mego para segurundi tamo ta kutingo matangeni nga ulula kuta iyo na kupya bonga shante nyanga fio ha
ku obura shi tatu putuka aita mekike na ngomu eta mekike na ngomba obura ohea o teika shura na marit. Geno paife hino ano tari nalo makundi.
Ni non longo no goi. Aka pena wa ya mepsa nande nande.
Unlike 2019 that was also bad, but this time around you can see those who have cultivated their land, the germination began or it's already dying, burned by the sun.
Shige ni nganga shi omite nyangode ya ngaha. Ya uno kulongi for meva.
Ah, yuna ndisha kene ka. Kwa dile ngodule imuinya dile kona yo. Shungu ali ili wali ambara ngashi. Katutele nande nande no.
Yes, I pay for mepsa kashi durali. Yashina anu kuya atulimi tuwa stopa. Yashito duru kulo kulonga ngengo shi mita shiku eteri ima tiashi.
Adinyoko inga adiloko. Yashi dinyato toko dinyato aja. Watuka dinyato lokuwa munde zemba na enuwa nina februari. Datugalo kwa mungu durando atukadi. Deto paisa sa atindi ya tumono na wana.
Durana ndo kuri na iloka ukukuto hau ya nontenya ni ukala uhapu nene ngashi ne kominga ya nima mwatu na mwule ma ashiva tukatuwe kwa mungu mundi. Ngashi ne ngashi ngeno abatu na mwule maipa atudengwa kene ndetango
and the farmers are really struggling to share the portable water that we supply to the community with their animals.
Oyongota itushunifa pedu taishunifa ongaro pedu.
Wazama paise shacho tukita katuete kucha paifo patira. Katuete kucha ngumu tu ato mononoka. Tafatu mononoka odura inyatwa jayi.
In response to the impacts of climate change, the government of Republic of Namibia, through the Ministry of Environment, Forestry and Tourism, have developed a climate change policy in 2011. This is basically a very important legal instrument that set out all the mitigation and adaptation actions that a country should employ to adapt to the impacts of climate change in various sectors of our economy. So, as a ministry, we cannot fulfill our mandate and objective that we have set ourselves if we are doing it alone. So, various projects such as this one, CDKN, have really helped us to achieve our objectives.
The Oshana region is one of the beneficiaries of the CDKN-funded GRECA project, This project stands for Gender Responsive, Climate Resilient, Rural and Community Development for Shana and Omsati Regions.
This project is a spin-off from the international project that UNAM was leading a Namibian case study on. That project was looking at barriers and enablers to adaptation in Namibia. We have already held capacity building workshops where we have introduced the climate change impact, the climate science, and what the policy says and strategy.
The project has been working to strengthen the relationship among government departments, support the mainstreaming of gender and climate change into rural development strategies, and enhance local participation in income-generating activities.
The issue of gender mainstreaming, it's very, very important. You see, our women are highly vulnerable to the impacts of climate change.
Climate change impacts men and women differently, so the impacts are gender differentiated. And the way to respond, the adaptive capacity is also gender differentiated. So we want the Ministry of Gender to take the lead.
I would say women are more affected because if we look at roles that they play in the society or in the families, they take up most of the roles. Imagine a woman that is supposed to get up every day to go plow in the Mahangu field, for example, and now all of a sudden it's not raining, so this woman must be very, very stressed by now, and at the same time she must still look after her kids, and maybe there were no other means of surviving other than what comes from the Mahangu field.
Among other activities, the project has carried out the climate change capacity building workshop for the Oshana Regional Council, the vulnerability risk assessment exercise for the region, as well as the Ongwediva Constituency Development Committee training. The Constituency Development Committee comprises of diverse individuals from different sectors with the main purpose of coordinating developmental planning at the constituency level.
They advise the councillor as well on what kind of development should be done within the constituency. The training that we're having today, especially on the issues of governance and advocacy, fits in very well with the CDC's work because they're involved in development activities. So we want them to understand their roles.
My expectations from this training is for the participants to learn and to leave with something. So we want to leave them with not only knowledge, but skills. We want to capacitate them in order for them to better do their jobs, in order for them to better serve the community.
Unenenge takuta kumata kutoa climate change. Kandi shikucha, utashitinge ipi. Nde kuja moshi ongeo moshi nyatuwa ningrenyo kumbwede bako trade fair. Nda jama nda monda shiva kucha. What? Oshike? O climate change, utashitinana, nge ipi leo.
Ah, moshi ongeo munda nangondi jema ngeno. Dino kumo kukalombola kwetu kucha ngengu nuju nando oshi mangoshi pumbwire pukululo otoduru kwendi.
Natumona nale njara ndishi upeke tuwe tome pwesi ya shinja pife ngaha pamana ne kucha mboli onu no kukatanga ipi ikulia opo wehi hepeke.
Ndino ngame ne kucha ngengo bende ngengo nanike dirikola ndo ndino mwenyo. Shanga ndamono kucho ngaro ya upyota ende ngalipi. Andi tameke, andi landi fapo dimwe. Sinda andi fapo himwe. Imaru andi kei dini na kompanga. Odurata kuro kwa mea, andi kei kufakwa nindi karangu nindi pungo biwamu. Hidendi, imaru andi kei rongi fokuranda omuidi. Wengo be nano dota di upu po donda fi opina.
That's what I got that really stood out for me is that organizations need to make an effort to come here more and to really capacitate the people of Ongwediva.
And we have to inform our community that climate change is here to stay with us. And we cannot just sit idle waiting for government, waiting for our mighty road to assist us. We have to turn the negative impact of climate change into opportunities.
So we are supporting to farmers to grow something, especially vegetables, and sell to get income to the community or to our hamba in Ongwediva, and also to farm with chicken. They sell eggs or chicken for meat.
This is what we want so that people are able to know that by themselves
they're able to work together to improve their own livelihoods.
Community members, through the constituency development committee trainings, are educated about climate change and the existing climate change adaptation opportunities, such as brick making and the selling of products extracted from natural resources.
Ifo ta tuningine taninga no ngenda bara kuja na tuninge kuma sasa ite yalipo oyakulupa yonga singana nechapo endo danalo kuya didipa ndo iti mominhulo taife na mendo damo ta didika no makuma diditunga no makuma ngashi no malimba nenjo ngashi ngamwete no njo ilingao ifo titunga no nekuma
anu apumba kukala tarongifa ini miti drugu omiti tadika pamunacho no durite ilokonga mwezi pamana pomiti ai o showa nengo nadi gino kwa tusha tukarata ta kufonga twe kucha twe feiti jazine ngenge no walongo nawa metande ngaji i matiri nawa ekupanawa nena homono ka profeta kashon jazpe ifene kashidurali ivo torongo aka toka pungula wali toka turaike mepunda na tanga kashiduri
popo nditameke no shikuko opondi ninge o project ka ekukwa ndaka kalandina omumbwe okufutira uno na bango skola nokumwana yo oshimaliwa shoku yako shipangelo nokujapwe kuhado dakala tadendelenge na wa Highland fangope skola do popepinase okuchango handi durukulandisa ame handi duruku kalanda tarameta ngeno okwali kunoloka ushosho tuwa utulapo ima ndeto kunu pwiri mahangu nga otete apo oshiru shosho wiha uyere kwano na wengo beni kom
ya nashinenda manodura yo ne nda kenda baranga kongironga no shakara ne sha ju palerange ngo handi kabwa twane kwa madiradiro ku tameko shikunino ya opongo ndianja kaneko unongo kwa shiwana ya no kulonga ngi kulia moshiwana ngashi tulimo ngaha
proyeka yo ya totako iyongo eilipo iyoyo hakutuwa kucho ili engudu dili mbali ngudu imwe oina HIV ngudu imwe kaina oilio opositive ela la kanoro proeka okutota oshima shiri mo community tete posha shena shetu monengenge atumono mo iemo opo tuli kwa fengo nasho atuduruguri kwa sanasho ngengo dulalo kaiha tukatalaji mea kwile tunetalele tolo kataloko kiliopoko kwa haka dome yako kone hatudurukulongifa atutekelini maeto
ndiga dukatare viko shana satu hatu hongo soeni
edo hatulitameke tali hatulitutike de hatulime nga hatunya mushuranga ha de hatutameke okulima hatuninga hatushumbumu ailandi fanandi ilyanga sho shumbore shikukuta wiro uno shimaliwa ailandi fa fikulime mepyange inanga shinga inanjasha oshukukuta na niyo weta tuirongere ya kukuta ya pia poko ntenya. Ndengengo efimbo linyaro kufika nengengere ya andi duru kuhonga. Ya tutamekenga na ndena aguste. Tatamekana aguste tuka kemwe jodo.
The Marula oil production through the Tilenge project is a beneficiary of the project's small grants.
Poleka yo Tilenge project. Poleka yo ya kweke yetu yo pumwene. Aturombo atulukalande goma huku tatameke ke aturanda sha goima ike tuneko kashinaga kamwa ke si aturanda sha goima ike tayanga tuwe tengo jeta aturanda sha godrimbali tuwe tengo jeta kuna tuwe tengo jeta kufi aya atukalanda ku atukalanda mahuku akulu peke vipata bomungu ndeke mikunda vipata iku kuni kumwe apa atukalanda mahuku penano penango kapale ke lipopo ne atu angeke bongala atukalanda mahuku
The marula is a fruit that grows in north central Namibia. Traditionally, when the fruit is mature, women extract the juice for home consumption and put the fruit stone aside. The fruit stone is then broken open to extract the kernel from the shell. That kernel is then pounded to extract the marula oil. Pounding the kernel is time-consuming and only small quantities of oil are produced. Thanks to its press, the Tilenge project is able to process much larger quantities of kernels and extract much larger quantities of oil, making it a profitable business venture.
At the end of this project, we are happy that we would have identified a platform at regional level where climate change will be institutionalized. In that way, we could say we have decentralized climate change in Namibia.
So we want this type of initiative to be rolled out to other regions. We will be really happy to see this initiative, you know, happening also in other regions.
Ultimately, the GRECA project has strengthened the relationship between government departments through the various activities undertaken. The project has raised awareness of climate change at the regional level and has assisted the regional council staff with the identification and prioritization of issues to be addressed. The project ensured gender dynamics and social differentiation among community members were factors taken into account when developing rural development strategies. The project model developed is replicable and other regions can benefit from GRECA's learnings.
Mapia yetu inafuta po.